Today, I'm going to show you how to build an AI agent that knows not only what to think, but also how to think, so that when it receives a message from a user or some data that it needs to process, instead of just querying an external knowledge base, it will be able to contact an ontology of reasoning that we will define as a knowledge graph with the thinking rules, and then use those rules in order to augment the final response that it's going to provide to the user. And you can define these rules to be anything you want. It could be Alex's Hormozzi's framework, or it can be your own framework. In our case, we'll be using the cognitive variability framework that helps to overcome obstacles in thinking or in physical development. And then it's like you have access to this external brain and the logic of this brain so that you can provide responses that will be augmented with that reasoning logic. So this is not extracting the context, it is actually extracting the rules of reasoning that you can then apply to the way that this agent thinks and provides results. So if you're interested to learn how it works, keep watching and I will demonstrate it step by step. Also, please subscribe to this channel so that other people can get informed about the videos on this topic. So let's dive right in. So here I will be using n8n for demonstration, but you can use any agent framework like CreAI, or you can program it yourself, doesn't matter. I'm using n8n just so that you have a visualization of what's happening under the hood. And if I ask a question, like for instance, I feel that my business is stuck, what to do, right? So when I ask this question, normally, what's going to happen is that it's going to go to reasoning agent and OpenAI will provide an answer. But in our case, it actually goes to the special external brain with the ontology that we defined. In this case, it's going to go here. It's going to find, based on similarity search, the part of the graph that relates to the question that we asked. So in this case, it's going to be something about stagnation, saturation, regular variability, and then it will go to fractal variability. So it extracts the part of the brain of the graph of the reasoning logic that is important for our specific context. And here, if you click on the nodes, you can actually see which statements they are, right? So it's going to extract the most relevant statements, the most relevant rules, and then it's going to feed them back into this agent's workflow so that the second time that the query goes to OpenAI, now it's going to be augmented with these reasoning rules that we defined in our ontology. So the answer that will be provided will be much more specific to the thinking process that we want to promote. And also it's going to be much less generic than the normal stuff you would get from OpenAI. So for example, here, it's telling us that, if we want to overcome this feeling of being stuck in business, we need to focus on regenerative rhythm, on fractal networks, on adaptive fluidity, and also modulating tension dynamics, complex iteration and narrative ethics. So these are exactly the insights that are based on the reasoning logic that we defined in this knowledge graph. If you ask that same question here in the standard workflow, where you actually don't have access to that external brain, where it's just using OpenAI, you will see that the response that we get to this same question is much more generic. It's just kind of telling us, okay, you should focus on the situation, engage your team, interact with your customers, innovation and adaptation. So these are all good advices, but they're very generic. They're not specific to our particular context. In this case, we're actually using the knowledge that we ourselves defined and developed as a set of rules, as a knowledge graph, and then we ask the model to use this knowledge to augment its response to the user. So the results that you get are much more precise, much less generic, much less biased also, and much more specific and focused on whatever value you want to provide to the user. And like I said, in our case, we're using the cognitive variability framework, but you could use any framework you want. You could use Alex Hormozzi's rules for building the best possible offers. You could use Ray Dalio's frameworks for investment. You can use psychotherapy frameworks, philosophical frameworks, anything you want. And I'm going to show you how you can actually define them. Okay, so let me show you how you would build something like this step by step. We'll be using n8n for building this workflow, but you can use any other framework like CreAI, or you can also program it yourself. I'm just using n8n to give you a better demonstration of all the steps involved in the process. So first, we need to create some trigger node that will start this conversation, right? It can be a chat message, it can be an external webhook that would receive a message from Telegram or WhatsApp. It could be a collection of PDF documents and then the question generated from them, doesn't matter. As soon as we receive something, it goes to the reasoning agent. The reasoning agent is a node that we can create by choosing AI agent here. When we create this node, it's going to be added here. We need to add a system message that will describe how this AI agent thinks. So I'm going to show you how we describe this agent. I'm going to provide a link also in the description to this video where I will explain what the prompt is. But basically it's saying here that you're a reasoning agent. You have access to a dynamic interaction expert that provide you advice on how to continue your interaction. So we're telling this AI agent what expert, what reasoning logic it has access to, okay? And then it says that when you send a request to this expert, you need to give it an interpretation of the previous interaction and its dynamics using the language and concepts that the reasoning agent will understand. So this is very important because we're telling the agent, don't send the original query, rephrase the query in a way that would be relevant for this agent. This is how we tell it not what to think, but how to think, right? And then when you receive the answer from the expert, then you augment with that answer your own answer, and that's what you send to the user. So you see there are actually several steps involved, and this is why we're using the agent node here. And then what happens next is that when this query is received from the user, it's going to first go into the OpenAI, it's going to rephrase it. So here you can actually see in the log how it works. When I asked it, I feel that my business is stuck, what to do? It goes to the memory, then it goes to the OpenAI chat. It's creating a new prompt. Instead of, I feel that my business is stuck, what to do? It's rephrased it by saying the user expresses a feeling of being stuck in their business, indicating a sense of stagnation and possibly frustration. This prevents a dynamic. That's very important. It knows it's going to talk to a dynamics expert. So this is why it's rephrasing it to use the term dynamic that may involve a need for motivation strategies to rejuvenate their business operations. The user is looking for actionable advice or strategies to overcome this hurdle. So now that it rephrased this, it's going to send it to this knowledge graph expert, to this external brain, using the language that this brain will understand. It receives the answer from this brain, right? And then it feeds it back to the AI chat model, and then it provides the final answer, which is augmented with the output from the knowledge graph that told it how it can think about this problem. And here is the second important element that comes in, because when you create this reasoning agent, so that's an AI agent node, right? You need to connect it to a chat model. So you will just click here on chat model, and then you will connect it to whatever chat model you want to use. Then you need to connect it to simple memory so it can have memory of the conversation. But the important thing here is the tool that you're going to connect it to. And when you click tool, you will choose the HTTP node, and then you can use the InfraNodus API post request. I'm going to link in the description to this video to the actual workflow that we're using here, so you can just reuse it in your own n8n. And what we're going to do here that's very important, when we open this node, in the description of this tool, we will describe what this agent is an expert in. So we're saying that it's an expert in interaction dynamics, because that's what the cognitive variability framework is about, right? We're describing that, okay, this is what you know. You will be dealing with people and situations, because this is what the cognitive variability framework is good for. It's helping us to think how to deal with tension, how to release tension, how to deal with stagnation, how to basically develop any situation and let it evolve, right? So we're describing all that, but on top of that, we also give an overview of the structure of this thinking logic. And this, I'm going to show you how you do that in a second. And we will also provide the name of this graph. Okay, so we will link to this graph here. And now I'm going to show you how you can build this graph. So when you go into the name of the graph that you will be using, you need to specify a graph from InfraNodus that you created with a specific thinking logic that you want to use. So in this case, I'm using this n8n expert. I'm going to show you in a second how you build this graph. But basically, I have this n8n expert graph here. I simply paste it here, right? And then I need to give the AI agent in n8n an additional context to help it understand what this agent is about. Of course, I gave it a description of the agent here, right? Just with my own words, but I also need to give it some more technical information. So here in InfraNodus, you actually can generate project notes, auto-generate from analytics. So it's going to take all the main topics that it identified in this text, and it's going to create a summary of them here. This is what this graph is about. And we simply copy this content and paste it under our description. Okay, so you will see that it has not only our own description, but also what are the main concepts, what are the main topics, with all the different types of concepts that exist inside, and even the relations between them, and the main relations also that exists out there, even the sentiments, so that the model understands a little bit better what this expert is good for and how it should rephrase questions for this expert in order to generate the best possible results. And then the rest is going to be done by InfraNodus. You will simply connect to the InfraNodus API here, and then it's going to connect to this graph, A2S expert, and generate a response, right? So this is how this whole workflow actually works, and this is how you get that final result. And now let me show you how you would build the graph in InfraNodus. So you would go back to InfraNodus, and then you would go to the apps page. And here you basically have several approaches. If you want, you can build something from scratch without any external intervention. You just go to explore a topic, and then you click on generate AI ontology, and you can type in here any framework you want to use. So for example, I want to use Ray Dalio's investment framework and rules, right? So I'm giving it a prompt, and then I click visualize, and what InfraNodus is going to do is that it's going to generate a knowledge graph of ontology of this particular framework and the different reasoning rules that play an important part in this framework, right? So for instance, here it's telling us how transaction costs can erode investment returns and should be considered in portfolio management here, right? And then, for instance, overconfidence can lead to excessive trading and increased transaction costs. So here, if this knowledge graph, if this external brain was to be used by an AI agent, it would be able to extract all those thinking patterns, depending on the user query, and then use them in order to augment the response with Ray Dalio's wisdom. And you can actually build this graph in a few iterations. So if you feel like this is not enough, you can click again here, add more AI generated stuff, and you can be more specific. For instance, Ray Dalio's thinking on investment, right? And you add this extra information to this graph. So this is how you would build this automatically. You can also build it semi-automatically by adding an existing text that you have as a starting point and then adding your own connections after. So this is how I actually built the graph that I'm using. I have this description of the cognitive variability framework here on the four states of variability. So I simply copy this text. I can actually take the whole text here, or just the first paragraphs. And then I go to the apps page, and here I just add this text as a new text, but I choose generate knowledge graph with the prompt. Okay, so instead of adding the whole text as a text, I'm generating a knowledge graph, so it's going to be a little bit more precise. And here it has this text that I created, and now I'm going to create a new graph from it. And what it's going to do is that it's going to extract from this text some reasoning rules and build a knowledge graph from them. So that will be kind of like starting this process in an automatic way by showing me the main ideas. So for instance, I see here it relates a lot about the discourse and variability, but I can also see that, for instance, the notion of network may be related to network structure, right? So I can select these two nodes and just add this connection here, network structure parameters define the way network operates, right? So I'm adding this additional rule, and here you see they will be connected. And then if I want to add something else, I can say that, for instance, variability is important for resilience, right? I add this here, I'm creating more constellations. I can say that an optimal network structure parameters for resilience are related to small world networks. So something like this. And then I keep on adding more and more rules and connections in order to give the system an understanding of my reasoning logic, right? And this is how I will build it step by step. First, generate some stuff at the beginning just to have a starting point, and then add some connections manually. Especially, I like to connect these small islands together, right? If I see that, for instance, small scale should be connected to exploration, I can copy those, add a link, save. Now they're connected, and I can describe the relations so that when the model extracts this part of the graph, it's going to have access to this reasoning logic. And this is how it's going to work. You know, when it receives a query, if it's something in relation to resilience, it's going to extract this part of the graph. It's going to have all this logic available to it, how resilience is related to variability, how it's related to small world network structures. And then it's going to feed that information into the model, into the AI agent, and help it augment the response. So this is how it would work. When you build an agent, then you connect it to an external knowledge graph that you can generate inside InfraNodus and then use it as the reasoning logic. There are some other flows available to you. So if you don't want to use the reasoning agent, you can also just build a flow where you just use the chat trigger and the InfraNodus node to augment the prompt. So I have one here. It's actually using reprompt parameter in the request mode. It says reprompt, not response. And then it will regenerate a prompt based on the logic of this graph. And then you can connect it to some other knowledge. In this case, I'm actually using the news of the day. So I'm basically telling the system, okay, when you receive a message from the user, for instance, what to do about the situation in the world today, you will have access to this reasoning logic. You will rephrase the question based on the reasoning logic that I provided to you. And then you will use that reasoning logic in order to query information from a graph, which is a different graph. It's the graph of the news of the day. So think about the news from the perspective of cognitive variability. And then it's going to provide a response that will be using a different logic than this AI normally would use. So this is really good for interdisciplinary explorations if you want to explore how one way of thinking could be applied in some other context. I'm going to make another video soon on that, so please subscribe so that you can get informed when it comes out. So I hope you find it interesting. I will link to all the workflows in the description to this video below. If you have any questions, let me know. And also, if you have any feedback, I will be really curious to hear about your experience using this workflow, because I find it very interesting and promising, and I hope you will have good results from it. Thank you.